Although spread betting has been around for more than 30 years, it's really been the last 5 or so years where it's grabbed the enthusiasm of private investors. It's one of the fastest growing products amongst private clients in the UK, and it's not difficult to see why. Spread betting is a very straightforward concept to understand. It's simply a product that mirrors the performance of an underlying financial instrument. So for example, with spread betting on a share like Vodafone, if you were to buy £5 per point and the share price was to go up, the spread bet price would go up as well. If the spread bet price went up 10 points, then that would represent a profit of £50. If the spread bet price dropped by 10 points, that would represent a loss of £50.
Shares, futures, options, whatever it is you're trading, your profit or loss is governed by the price you buy at and the price you sell at. But unlike other forms of trading, spread betting, first of all, does not attract commission and it does not attract stamp duty, which represents a real saving for traders and investors alike. But the reasons why people use spread betting are not just limited to the savings over other forms of trading. When trading financial markets using spread betting, again, whatever you're trading, whether it's an individual share, a stock index, a commodity, clients can trade these markets both up and down. Traditionally, for example, the way to profit from stock markets is to buy low and hopefully sell higher up. This is all well and good when markets are rising, as they have done for the past few years, but it can be difficult in a sliding market. Spread betting allows you to try and profit from a fall in the price of a financial instrument. Let's use an example to illustrate this. If you think the UK stock market trading at 6,400 is overvalued and is due a slide, what you could do with spread betting is sell short. You'd sell first at 6,400 because you expect at some point in the future, whether it's the next few minutes, days, weeks, months, whatever, to be able to buy it back cheaper and realise a profit from the slide in that financial instrument. Another appeal of spread betting is the fact that it is a leveraged product. You trade on margin. Margin is a way of making your trading capital go further. A small amount of money controls a much bigger financial position. Let's spend a bit of time looking at risk management. Trading on margin increases your risk because you can potentially lose more than your initial deposit. However, there are many ways of managing this risk with a range of flexible orders such as stop loss orders. Many spread betting companies offer clients the opportunity to use a controlled risk bet, a CRB. CRBs enable you to place a stop order at a predetermined level in order for you to guarantee your maximum loss. Therefore, you have a known worst case scenario should the market move severely against you. Because they guarantee the price at which the trade is stopped, there are normally conditions to this type of order. But spread betting isn't only about trading on shares. Clients have access to, for example, stock indices, commodities, stock sectors, treasuries, and currency markets from as little as £1 per point. This small trade size means that traders can take on as much or as little risk as they feel suitable for their own requirements, and they can start trading markets that previously they may not have considered, such as foreign exchange, for example, on a much smaller scale than was the case just a few years ago.